Hi, welcome back. Annette here. Hope everybody's doing okay. I'm getting a little bit more regular here now with my shows. So welcome to my rug hooking and new loom knitting talk show. So for those of you who know, have been watching, I do rug hooking. But I've recently fallen in love with loom knitting. So I'm just bringing what I know of loom knitting and sharing about different yarns. And so it's been fun. And it's also been really nice to kind of get through the winter with another craft. And I've been knitting lots of gloves for friends and my family and lots of hats. So that's been kind of cool. I still have yet to knit a hat for myself. What is up with that? But I'll get to it. So, so I've been working on the rug. I have been working on the rug. And, I did on my blog, the WordPress blog that many of you have been subscribing to, I did not upload pictures. I was having some problem. My little notebook, my little Samsung Chromebook broke, and it literally exploded. I woke up one morning and it was like normal one day, and the next day it was like puffed. So something inside expanded, blew up, whatever. And my iPad died. So I've been kind of restricted to just using my phone, which I've been exploring more and loading pictures through that and sending it to emails and going up on the big PC upstairs, so it's kind of slowed me down a little, but I think I'm getting better at it. Anyway, so I did try to, you know what, I am going to take this off to show you what is going on with this. I tried to do it with the camera the other day and it was not working, so let's do it this way and take everything off. There we go. Okay, let's see. Okay, alrighty. If you're working on a rug, I find it really helpful to clamp it as you go along. I don't like this big thing kind of flopping around when I work, and sometimes it hits up against your knees, and it's just kind of uncomfortable. So basically, that's what my little clamps are used for. 'Cause once the rug starts getting finished, it really does start getting heavy. And I could see how they were originally called bed rugs, because they would put them on the foot of the bed to add warmth. And that's a really, you could make a bed rug for your own bed, and that would be really pretty. And not use it for the floor, but use it for extra warmth if you have, like, you know, those cold feet syndrome. Okay, so here we go. Let's see if I'm getting it in. Okay. I think I'm going to even stand. Wow. Okay. I think this is the first time in a few months I've seen it off of here. So there you go. And it's coming along. I'll give you a little close up. You know, there's nothing super artistic. There's no crazy shading in this. And it's just a happy little rug. Let's see, it's a little curled up over here. You can see there's a little scalloped edge. I'll get a real good close up. Just trying to give you a little idea of what's going on. There you go. Okay. Okay. I did it. That wasn't too bad. Okay, so those of you who are new, welcome. If you're returning and you're kind of enjoying the show, great. I'm glad I'm giving you a little company while you're rug hooking, because that's what this is all about. And if you're joining in because you're a loom knitter, well, wow, that is really, really good to know. I'm excited to have you be a part of my loom knitting journey. So, yeah, there you go. So that's what we're working with. I have a little heater on down here because it kind of, in New England now, the cold is starting to kick in a little here and there. Not as bad. No snow, and it's been awesome. So I have my little cup of tea, and somebody once said on another podcast, why do we feel compelled to tell everybody what's in our cup? And I always thought that was a little weird, but I just felt it was almost like I'm sitting talking to some friends, so they should kind of know what I'm drinking. So there you go. That's kind of why I do it. It's not because I'm telling you you should be drinking anything, but yeah, I just figured we're all sitting and hanging out together. So I'm having tea and whatever. So join me and get whatever you're going to get. I like the orange spice. You don't need to add any sugar or anything to it. Not that sugar's, you know, if that's your thing, go for it. But I just kind of like not doing the white sugar stuff so much. Honey, not too bad. Okay. Actually, I enjoy holding that mug just because it warms me up. Okay, so you've seen what I'm doing with my rug hooking. And only because I have so much to share on my Loom knitting stuff. And somebody shot me a little message through Rug Hooking Daily asking if I would, or maybe it was just, I'm sorry, maybe it was just a comment on one of the previous videos to show the loom and what I do with that. So, okay. Basically, these are the looms, okay? This is what you'll probably find in like a Michael's or Joann's, Hobby Lobby, that sort of thing. These are what are called, this is a really good one of these, okay? Why they don't, this wood prevents it when you're holding it in your lap from sliding down. And I think most of us who loom knit like to hold it in our lap. And so it doesn't slide. The pegs are awesome. They're just a little bit bigger than that. Well, no, they're probably exactly the same size. I'm sorry. These are set a little closer. Here we go. Excuse me for turning on my back on you. This is your 5/8 inch spacing. This is what this is. This is your basic loom. And that's what I got for the little ones. And this is what I use to make my gloves, okay? This is a 1/2 inch width. So it produces a little tighter weave, but a bigger piece of fabric. So it starts to get a little tricky. You know what I've learned? That I really just like the 5/8 and it works for me. Now, it also comes in a 3/8 inch, which is a little further than the 1/2 inch. And again, I've used this to make gloves for my daughter. And what is nice about this, you use this little finer gauge one, or the pins are a little tinier, with your DK weight and your sport weight. And I probably wouldn't go below a sport weight. I don't know, fingering would, I mean, that's like sock yarn, isn't it? So I've never done socks, but I have made gloves using a lighter worsted and a sport weight. And they did come out really nice, except they take forever. And this is not that easy to work, just for the record. There's a little tiny space in there where you pull up the, sorry for the back. Okay, so this is the hook you use. So as you can see, there's a little tiny space in that peg where it slides up and down to make it easy. Well, obviously you can see on this one, it is a lot bigger, that little center thing. So it's a lot easier to work with this. And this works, to me, this is perfect with worsted weight. And maybe even, if you like bulky, this works fine with that. You might want to start going to something like this if you like to work with sport and DK, that sort of thing. So basically, that's it. Now, I recently bought a little tiny loom. And I'll just show you in relativity, size-wise, what we're looking at here. Yeah, it's a little tiny guy. Wood also. And this one is, they're shaped a little differently, but it still worked. From Cottage Looms. Okay, and here she has it in the back. Cottage Looms on Etsy. There you go. And she makes bigger ones too. So if you like this style, you know, check her out. So what I did, I made my fingerless gloves using this one. Here we go. Oh, let me see if I could do it. Okay. So when I make a fingerless glove, it does not have this. It does not have the thumb. It comes out like that. So, and these were These are from Encore, Plymouth Encore yarn, which I really, you know what? It's an acrylic with a wool, and it's very, very soft. Yeah, it's really nice. It's not an inexpensive, it's about $6 to $7, depending on the style, but it's all worsted, and they have like 4 million colors and tweeds, and you name it, they've got it, so it's an awesome, awesome selection, and my local yarn store carries it. So there you go. That's what they came out looking like. That's the gauge. Let me see if I can get it close. See that? Okay. And that's the yarn. It's got a little bit. It's a heather. I think it's midnight blue or something like that. But anyway, so this little loom with an E-wrap as opposed to a flat U-wraps makes the thumb. Okay. So, there you go. And you can get two sizes. If you E-wrap it, you'll get the bigger adult size. If you do a flat knit, you'll get a little, here you go. Let me take this out. You'll get a little child size thumb. Okay? It's little. It's a littler. Okay? So, you can get two sizes out of that little one. And for those of you who are really into making your fingerless gloves like me, I give them away to everybody who wants them, can get them. Yeah, so I made a pair with the little, I'm going to put one on so you can see exactly what it does. There you go. One thumb came out a little longer than the other because I wasn't good writing down how many rows, so one thumb is a little longer. And so usually I write down as I'm working. Let me see if I can get a slip. Excuse me. Okay. I used that. It fell. My loom just rolled away. And that's my pattern. And as I do it, I just put a mark. So at the end, I can see if, oh gosh, I missed one. I can do it before I move on to the next section. Yeah. So it would be the cuff, the wrist, the thumb, and then the finger part. And so I make copies. I make Xerox copies and cut them and make a whole page, and so I don't run out. So I just adjust it to whatever I'm working with. So there you go. And that is how these little looms work. So if you're a loom knitter like me, you are always interested in new looming stuff and yarns and that sort of thing. So today I just wanted to show you what. Showed you the Encore yarn, and where'd we go? Bam, right here. Sorry. Yesterday, in honor of Super Bowl, my yarn basket store had a sale, a secret sale. You take what you want to buy up to the counter, and then they give you anywhere between 15 to 50% off on a little secret thing that you open up and check. So mine was 40% off. So yay! So I bought some more Encore yarn. This is the color spun. It's like $6.50. The regular is without any extra color, just solid colors, or $6. But you get 200 yards, and it really is nice. And I made a neighbor a hat, and it's still working out really good for him. So there you go. And this is it. So that's this one, and this color is okay. Alrighty. There's no color on here. 7600, but it does have a name. I don't know why it wasn't. It's just not on here. Okay, so there you go. It's like a pretty black tweed. Okay, and as soon as I start knitting my gloves up on that, I will show you. And I got another one. And this, I just was so interesting. It's like I don't know, it's got like three colors, like a gray, like a pumpkin-y color, and like a deep wheat color. And it is so pretty. Yeah, so again, these will be gloves, or this might be a hat. So we'll see what that turns into. I've yet to make myself a hat. Okay, so as I was exploring the different anti-pill yarns, which I love for gloves because they're always touching something, And so they kind of, I tend to think, might pill a little bit more. So I kind of like, safety-wise, I don't want to give my gloves to somebody and they're like, they look really nasty after about a month of wearing them. So this was the Hobby Lobby yarn in Brownie, their new line of anti-pill yarn. If you don't like shopping at Hobby Lobby, I get it. But I'm just sharing for those, for information, this is what this was. And a big old skein, as I showed you in the last show. So these are the gloves. And this is on that standard 5/8 inch 24 peg loom from Cindy Wood. I think you could even get those in plastic from Michaels. They have them because that's the one I used to use, I think a little blue one. And so look, they came out really, really nice, and they're so squishy soft. And so yeah, these will be going to somebody. So that's the Hobby Lobby, and that's what it looks like. Okay. More. Not sure if I ever showed you these. I might have, but I did take some time off from doing the show. So this was Deborah Norville's anti-pill yarn, and it's a little variegated color. But it's variegated in some strong spots. So this is what happened. Okay, so apparently I didn't match these up very well when I made them. So they're a little different. Yeah, they're here. But again, this is what it knits up like, really close on that gauge. And I'm very happy. I don't think I need anything tighter than that. But like I said, if you like working with a thinner yarn, or you have a yarn that is just your go-to yarn, I like it, it's DK or sport weight, then you would definitely want to use the fine gauge loom, because when it stretches out with that thinner yarn, there's some spacing, and it's not, does not make for a warm glove, because your hand stretches into this a little bit, and it will open it just a tad. But you know, again, if you want to keep warm, you don't want a lot of space in between there. So I get that. Okay, so that was Deborah Norville. I got to be honest, the Deborah Norville yarn, this stuff is not as thick anymore in the variegated anymore. It's not. They've changed the quality. I absolutely think so. Okay, so more. We've got some more. Okay, so this was from Willow Wash. This was Willow Wash. Okay, yes, this was Willow Wash. It's their Super Wash wool. Again, it's like the Cascade 220, but you get 218 yards. So we'll call it Willow Wash, Willow Daily 218. And it's the Super Wash. And it's really nice. I mean, for $5.99, as opposed to eight and up, it's a good deal. So this is what that one knits up like. Okay. Now, somebody asked me, a friend said, do you crochet the edges? And I didn't realize it looks like a crocheted edge, but it's not. It's when I get to that last row, I do a purl knit all around, and then I do a bind off, so it doesn't curl. So there you go. Because if you go right into just binding it off and doing a flat knit all around, it will curl. Now, some people like that curly edge. So there you go. That's how you get it. You just don't do you don't throw any purls in there, and your edge will curl up for you. I don't particularly like it because I just don't like it. One more. Okay. So this is a Deborah Norville also. And this is an anti-pill yarn. And again, I gotta be honest, her yarn is not this thick anymore. This is not available. I'm telling you, if you go for it, you will not find something this thick. It just is not gonna happen. But that's how it knits up. And it's absolutely beautiful. Now, I'm not saying her yarn isn't great. I just thought it was greater. And now I think it's on the thinner side. But hear me out. You might like a thinner worsted because you just don't want anything bulky on your hands, especially gloves. So you know what? It's all good if you ask me. You'll have different types of gloves, which is always good to have. You don't want to have that. So yes, I did a lot of knitting over the weekend. I could do like two pair a day. So I was busy. And so there you go. That's a lot of that. And I will be continuing to do some more knitting and give them away. That's it. Some of them are going to California. And I know some people just love doing socks, and I'm trying to get into the sock thing. I really am, but I can't. To work on a sock loom, I think I would lose my mind, because this is the situation. I think I have what's called knitting ADD, and I can't really knit on one item for too long, or then I will not finish it. So if I can knit a pair of gloves in an hour or two, that works for me, or a hat, you know, I could do that. But anything longer, I got to do a long scarf. That would be really nice. I would like that. But I'm almost at the end. 1 minute. I'm almost at the end. Look at how many. Look at how many. These are the squares for the Afghan. Okay. I've got the last square. I believe it's the last square. I'll tell you right now. We have to do a count. We're going to do a count right now. So for those of you who have been on this journey with me, this is what I'm doing. Okay, so we got a solid pink, and this kind of, it's got pink and brown. Yeah. So we needed 10 of each. And I know I've got 10 of those pink ones. Let's see. Wow. So there you go. I've been doing, this is what I do at Knitting Group. I do these. It's mindless. It was knitting one direction, purling back. Knitting, purling. So there you go. And I forgot what that's called. Wow. Little blackout in the brain. Okay. That happens after 55. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yes, we have 10 of the solid pinks. We do. That is good to know. So let's see what I have. I haven't counted these in so long because it's been so long. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yes, the one on my loom now is number 10. It will be the last square. Yeehaw! Look at that. The last square, and then my granddaughter gets her Afghan from Grammy. Yes, very cool. Okay, so this is going to end soon, because like I said, 29 minutes, and then it shuts off, because it's really just a digital camera for taking stills, not videos, so the 29-minute thing is there. Yeah, so that's it. We have a lot going on, and a lot more as time goes on. So what else did I want to share with you? Trying to think. I hope you're all rug hooking, and please subscribe, share my video, give me a thumbs up, all that good stuff. Oh, I know what I wanted to share with you. I put it in my blog, but not everybody will read it. So again, I think I'm going to have to put my link from my WordPress blog back in there. Anyway, I'll put it down below somewhere. Dog Dare podcast is a really cool podcast with David, and he loves his dogs, and that always speaks to my heart. I had to put my little Tino down in October, and so that was really tough. My little best friend for 15 years, and so we had to say goodbye. What else? And Round Rabbit. She is a loom knitter, but she sews, and she sculpts, and she does all kinds of very cool things. Her name's Nancy, so I've subscribed to her recently, and I just wanted to share those two good things to you. And a shout out to Betty Collins, if you're watching, Betty. I didn't know if I ever shared this, but Betty from across the pond on Rug Cooking Daily, she sent me this little girl, my Fanway. And my granddaughter loves to play with her, and she is our little international traveler, because I've never been overseas. So this little girl represents She does my traveling for me now. She'll go everywhere my little granddaughter goes. Hopefully she'll always come back. And she'll be our traveling girl. But is she cute? Look at those little braids. So Betty, thank you so much. Elizabeth Collins. So she stays here. And then she goes upstairs on Fridays when I have my granddaughter. She'll come up and hang out with us up there. And she just likes to take her around and put her in wagons and stuff like that. So, okay, I think I've shared all that I could share. And I just want a shout out to all goodness in this world to come together and help us heal as a country, as a world, as a nation, as neighbors, as humans. There you go. So stay well and happy hooking, happy creating, happy knitting, happy sewing, and have a good one. See you soon. Bye.